Hello, I'm Kelly Williams, the Associate Director for Chemical, Biological, Radiological, and Nuclear Defense at Wright State University. This video will present a brief overview of the Seaburn Defense Certificate Program offered through the Bunshoff School of Medicine and the Department of Pharmacology and Toxicology. Chemical and biological threats have been involved in high-profile acts of aggression and terrorism. Thanks to the internet, the processes to develop chemical and biological agents are available to anyone with interest and achievable with a moderate level of education. Potential nuclear weapons from North Korea and Iran are frequently in the news. These threats drive political decisions around the world but represent a low probability, high consequence event. On a smaller scale, radiological threats can come from industrial sources and hospitals. Use of a radiological dispersal device has the potential to cause massive social and economic disruption. Not all threats of Seaburn origin come from acts of aggression or terrorism. Many incidents occur through accidental, natural, and industrial exposures. As of August 2017, there are 1,343 active Superfund sites under EPA supervision, which require long-term cleanup and present significant danger to people and the environment. Use of Seaburn agents may increase as they become more popular in the media and content we consume for entertainment. Dispelling popular myths may present challenges for responders and healthcare personnel who need to work in a Seaburn environment or respond to a local outbreak. Our product is the informed graduate. The goal of the Seaburn Defense Program is that graduates will understand the basic characteristics, effects, and responses to the most common Seaburn threats. They'll be able to apply the specialized knowledge when developing policies, treating patients, or conducting research. And they will be able to respond effectively if faced with a potential Seaburn incident. Graduates of the Seaburn Defense Program can directly apply their skills in a wide variety of exciting careers. Many companies are involved in Seaburn research and development to develop protective clothing, detection equipment, and decontamination methods. Emergency management personnel from local departments to federal agencies are actively seeking professionals with specialized academic backgrounds. Academic institutions around the nation are conducting cutting-edge research to combat Seaburn threats and develop novel treatments. All branches of the military and most three-letter agencies have groups responsible for combating weapons of mass destruction. It would not be difficult to find Seaburn work in a scope that suits your interests and abilities. The Wright State Seaburn Defense Program is the only one of its kind in the United States. We are the only institution to offer full-spectrum Seaburn defense, graduate-level detail and research material, medical response to Seaburn agents, and incident response case studies. The course content was developed by experts in their respective field who have dedicated their careers to Seaburn research. The Seaburn Defense Certificate is awarded to students who complete the three core classes, Chemical, Radiological, and Nuclear Defense, Biological Defense, and Case Studies in Seaburn Defense. These classes do not need to be completed sequentially, and they may be completed in one semester if a student is able to dedicate much of their time to the program. This would be considered full-time course load for graduate work. Flexible arrangements can be made for professional students with extenuating circumstances. Additionally, in-state tuition plus $10 per credit hour is offered for military service members and federal employees. In the Chemical, Radiological, and Nuclear Defense course, students will learn about blister, nerve, and pulmonary agents and will research current developments in medical treatment for these threats. Students will learn the fundamentals of radiation and study radiological and nuclear weapons. We will cover the nuclear fuel cycle and its impact on nuclear weapon proliferation concerns. The semester culminates in a research project on a student-selected toxic industrial chemical or material. Medical biological defense will present a brief history of biological agent use, fundamentals of epidemiology, microbiology, and the immune system. We will cover zoonoses and vector biology, and apply all this information to the most common bacteria, viruses, and biological toxins that present a threat to mankind. In the capstone project, students will serve as an epidemiologist during an outbreak of an emerging infectious substance. They will use their new knowledge to analyze environmental and wildlife reports, clinical signs and symptoms, and weather information to determine the causative agent. They will also make the case that this is a biological attack or if it is of natural origin. Case studies in Seaburn Defense presents the incident response fundamentals that guide national and local responses. We will study historic uses of Seaburn hazards through acts of aggression and nature. Our discussions on nuclear deterrent theories will provide a framework to analyze threats from emerging nuclear nations such as Iran and North Korea. Students will review current events in Seaburn news and address public health challenges in seaborne defense. The course content integrates a variety of media and regular evaluations. As an instructor, I want students to retain the principles of these courses, not memorize facts for a test and then perform a brain dump. If I run into a program graduate several years later, I'm confident we could hold an intelligent discussion about an emerging zoonotic outbreak or the challenges of contaminating a city's water system with biological material. Feel free to contact me for more information about the Seaburn Defense Program. You can also follow us on Facebook and find information at the Wright State page shown here.